Endometriosis is thought to be a rare disease, but it isn't. 10 to 20% of women in their reproductive age have endometriosis. In the world, women with histological diagnosis means that these women who have been operated for endometriosis are 176 million. So comparing this to 181 million women who have diabetes, this doesn't seem to be a rare disease. So we consider endometriosis as a tip of an iceberg because this is what we know. Women who suffer in silence, women who have symptoms but don't have a diagnosis, are much more. The biggest problem of endometriosis is the delayed diagnosis, because in Western industrialized, developed countries, the time that lapses between symptoms and diagnosis is between 9 and 11 years. 11 years of suffering, of having pain, of inability to have a baby, and of being not understood, because the patient goes to 1, 2, 3, 10 doctors and they don't understand what she has. So this delay in diagnosis, apart from the social impact, economic impact, and the psychological impact, not only on the patient but also on the couple, it's important, and that's why all our efforts in awareness campaigns and programs is to increase awareness about the disease, to decrease the time to have a diagnosis. Endometriosis has always been looked at like a disease of the ovary, of fertility, of pain. But now we are also getting more and more to better understanding of this disease and how it involves the nerves in a young woman. And this decreases also her functions, like urinary functions, rectal functions, sexual functions, and pelvic floor functions. It was thought to be the best treatment, radical treatment, remove everything, even at young age. But now we do not accept this. Also because the pathology of this disease is genetic, epigenetic, and this is something that's there. So there is no logic in a lady of 25 years old, remove her uterus and ovaries, you're not resolving the problem. That's why we are trying to fertility sparing and function sparing management to improve the quality of life of the patient.